Hello and welcome back to my channel. So we have all of this coffee and tea dyed paper. So now what do we do with it? So let's take a look at some options of things that we can do with it. We can, as we're putting our journal together, we can add the pages in to our journal, and they make great writing places. But there's some other things that we can do with it. So I have some, this is Chewy, 15% off. It came in the mail. So some of that junk mail we get, Chewy likes to send me lots of stuff that I don't order from them. But inside was this, and so I've taken it out. This I will also use and cover with some of the coffee dye paper. So here I have this card, and I want to create, or I want to make it, turn it into a nice writing space. So here's what I do. I just add some of this glue here, and I hope I'm in frame. All right, that might be better. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to add some of this glue because I ran out of my tape that I usually use. My tape runner is empty. And then I just like to smear it because I found that when I smear it everywhere and it's a thin, consistent layer, then it doesn't, it just makes it better. So I smear it everywhere using my Elmer's glue stick, and then I'm going to place it onto this paper. So this is going onto my tea dye paper, like so, and I will smooth it on with my wonderful smoothing tool. This is simply a ruler, one of those Tim Holtz rulers. Got it on the clearance rack. Gotta love clearance racks when we're crafting. We buy so much stuff. Okay, so then I just turn it over and repeat the process. And so you can do this with anything that you get, your envelopes that you get in the mail, any of that junk mail that you want to turn into writing spaces. This is something that you can do. So this time, oh, I gotta smooth it out first. And you know what I should have done? Because now it's gonna make it hard for me to cut it. And let me do that before I go any further. So I'm just gonna trim this off here like this.